Welcome to the Smoke Learning Channel. This video series will show you some digital beauty retouching techniques. In the previous video, we smoothed out areas of the skin to create a skin smoothing effect. However, when you blur something, you ultimately lose details and highlights. This video will focus on bringing back some of those details, but still keeping the retouched areas of the skin. If you would like to follow along, please click the link in the YouTube description to download the media. If you're watching the podcast version of this video, then type the link displayed in your internet browser. Now, a lot of these steps are optional, but I find that they will still help quite a bit. Let's look at the color channels to isolate the details and highlights on Matt's face. Hover over the Connect Effects node bin and press S for the Separate node. Drag the Separate node into the Connect Effects schematic and connect the Pixel Spread Remove Spot into the node. You will use the output from Pixel Spread and not the degrain clip because you want to extract the details without any skin blemishes. Double-click on the Separate node. The first color channel you will see in the result viewer is the red channel. Press F4 to switch to the green channel. Press F4 again to switch to the blue channel. The blue channel gives us much more skin detail and highlights to work with, so we'll go with this. The Separate node has a red, green, and blue output, so it's easy to figure out which connection to use. Now, we rarely need to push the detail and highlights out of this image. Switch to the Connect Effects node bin and press 2 to bring up the 2D histogram node. Drag it out and place it in front of the Separate node. Take the blue channel output and connect it into the 2D histogram node. Double-click on the node to see its controls. Now, drag the black levels to the peak of the histogram. This will push out everything other than the highlights. Drag the white level into the graph, and when you release the cursor, the highlights should stand out a lot more. We have isolated the highlights and details, but this includes the entire image and not just the areas we have been working with. So let's combine the face mask with this to create a matte for the detail pass. Switch to the Connect Effects node bin and drag out a Blend and Comp node. Rename this node to Detail Pass Matte. Connect the 2D histogram into the first red input of the Blend and Comp node. Now take the blue matte output from the Clean Skin Blur node and connect it into the second red front input. Double-click on the Blend and Comp node and change the blend mode to Multiply. This creates our final matte for the detail pass. The next step is to blend all the elements together. For this, we'll use another Blend and Comp node. Switch to the Connect Effects node bin and drag out another Blend and Comp node into the schematic. Rename this node to Blend Passes. Take the result output from the Pixel Spread Remove Spot node and connect it into the first red input. This input has all the skin details minus the skin blemishes. Now take the output of the Detail Pass Matte and connect it into the first blue input. Looking at the result viewer, you can see that we have the detailed pass waiting to be composited. Finally, take the result of the Blur Clean Skin and connect that into the second red input. You can see exactly where the detail will be applied, but it needs to be blended correctly. If you haven't already done so, zoom into the image and focus on the top half of Matt's face. Change the blend mode from Add to Min Darken. You can now adjust the transparency to your liking. Flicking between the Blend and Comp node and Blur node, you can see how we have smoothed out the skin and we have reintroduced the finer details. You can see this clearly when looking closely at the forehead. So the skin has been cleaned, smoothed, and the natural detail returned. You can keep refining this to your needs, and even include color corrections, etc. But now it is time to return back to where we started. In the final video, we put back the grain we originally removed. This will help finalize the changes we have made and properly blend things down. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe to the Smoke Learning channel for future videos.